Hi everyone, myself Amrita. I'm a product specialist from TopSolid India. In this video, we'll learn about driver block, how to create and use it in the projects. Driver block is a construction volume which makes it possible to create a boundary when making components such as shelves, partitions, drawers, doors, etc., which can be positioned and sized in a single click. Let's see how to create this. Let's go to wood context and select second function here, which says drivers or drivers block. There is a drop down which says two options: driver block and curved component driver. When you want to create a curved furniture, you go for second option here. But in this video, we will focus on creating rectangular driver blocks. When you select that, next dialog bar appears asking to define a name. I'm typing DB here and clicking OK. Next, need to fill out X, Y, and Z values. These are default values for the driver block. You can always edit these later. I'm giving 800, 600, and 900. I'll keep default housing mode as it is. This will be explained in the detail when we see usage of driver block. Then select the reference coordinate system for the placement. After this, fill out the designation of the driver block. I'm filling it as carcass, then pressing OK. Driver block is created on the screen. If you zoom in, you can see the characteristics of the same. In the history, you can see the values are created as parameters and you can modify them at any point in the design like this. I'll add panels to create a carcass, define all parts, and you can save it in your folder directly or as a standard template. Driver blocks can be used in 6 different ways. Let's see one by one. First, I'm making a rectangle and then extruding it to make a block. I'm giving some transparency to it. Now, let's call our unit inside this block. So I'm going to assembly, include a standard, selecting this carcass unit which we just made. When I click OK, here you can see it says housing inside a block, like a component, new contour, new sketch and dimension. These are the 6 ways I was talking about. So let's see the inside block option first. Inside block option makes it possible to retrieve the internal faces of a block during the insertion. With the block, it is then necessary to select the front face of the block like this, in which the component is to be inserted. Next option is housing. I'm selecting the shelf to place it inside this block or a carcass element which we have placed. Include standard, I'm selecting adjustable shelf. And here I'm selecting housing. And I'm selecting the bottom panel of the carcass. Housing is to automatically retrieve the external faces to make a component between several parts. Next option is like a component. This option retrieves the same faces of a component that has already been placed. For example, if shelf is created using a block like this, then while placing the door, if you select shelf component as a reference, the door is automatically positioned and sized. Okay, next option we see is new contour or new sketch. So we'll see both together. This mode allows you to draw a new contour or a new sketch like this, and it automatically asks for extrude value. And then I'll give some transparency to it. Then insert the component inside using the inside block mode. Next option is dimensions. This mode allows you to insert the component manually by entering the 3 dimensions on X, Y, and Z and then positioning it with constraints. This concludes the functionalities of driver block. For any other queries, please visit our channel. Thanks for watching.